Nashville Unlimited. We're just tickled to have you all here. And I'd like to introduce my co-host, who's going to introduce the next fella. Mr. Don Henry, make him welcome.
I never get nervous when I play very much, but I get nervous when I get introduced to somebody like this gentleman that I'm going to introduce. So anyway, my dad brought home, when I was a teenager, he brought home Randy Newman's Good Old Boys record in the same bag that he brought home, Old Number 9 by Guy Clark, and it changed my life. And Old Number 1, excuse me. See, I knew I was going to do that. I'm so nervous. But anyway, I will say that It changed my life, man, because I was sitting around listening to Elton John records all the time, and then all of a sudden I thought, well, I want to do this. This guy is the real thing. He's my Bob Dylan. This is Guy Clark.
You like Elton John too, huh? Well, this is just real civilized. We're a bunch of old field hippies. That's what public radio is, isn't it? Well, this is my dear friend Verlon Thompson here, playing guitar and singing. Y'all heard Brooks and Dunn, right? You know, Boot Scoot and Boogie. This is a song I lovingly refer to as the antithesis to the Boot Scootin' Boogie. It's called Out in the Parking Lot Where the Real Stuff Happens. Now sitting on the fender of someone else's truck, drinking Old Crow whiskey and hot 7-Up out in the parking lot. Well, you can hear the band playing right through the wall. There ain't no cover charge, there ain't no last call out in the park. In love. Now there's a couple of cowpokes putting up their dukes. Wasn't much to it after both of them puked out in the park in love. And then someone called the police, and the police finally came, and they wrote them a couple of tickets and they took a couple of names out in the park and love. Well, I'd love to see the neon dancing on the gravel. I'd love to hear the pickup trucks come unraveled. And some have given up and some have given in. Looks like everybody's looking for a friend out in the parking lot. Whoops, there's a couple who could not wait to get home. Oh, they're probably in love, so let's leave them alone out in the parking lot. And now the band is on the bus, they're all loaded up to leave. But the drummer's got a girlfriend and she's tugging at his sleeve out in the park. In love. Well, I'd love to see the neon dancing on the gravel. I'd love to hear the pickup trucks come unraveled. And some have given up, Some have given in. Looks like everybody's looking for a friend out in the parking lot. Now everybody's gone, and they've shot out all the lights. The dust begins to settle, and it's never been so quiet out in the parking lot.
Oh, thanks. Heard something interesting the other day. Interesting little piece of wisdom. You know, it's the early bird that gets the worm, but it's the second mouse that gets the cheese.
No! A real interesting point that guys brought up in the past talking about songwriting is that you haven't really completed the cycle of creating the song until you've not only recorded it, but then gone out and performed it.
Yeah, it's like the last extension of the writing process is playing it on the road for a couple of weeks and just see if it really works.
Have you had, with your last couple albums where you've had more control over the recording process, have you been able to kind of road test some of those songs?
Sometimes, record. I'm always running behind. You know, so sometimes I'm finishing it up in the studio, the song, so I've actually not been able to do that. But I wish I could. I think it's a great idea. This is a song Verlon and I wrote, and it's a duet, so we're going to do it together. One, two.
I used to be Juanita's old boyfriend. We sure gave him some stories to tell. Now I can't even find her picture. Looks like I'm finally through fooling myself.
Yeah, and I used to be an ex-bull rider. I was living on the edge of life itself. And now I can't even find my buckle. Well, I guess I'm finally through fooling myself.
So hang on just as long as you can. Get up whenever you fall. Shake it off, boys, and go around. Don't be hanging your life on the wall. Well, I used to be forever chasing fire trucks. I sure could raise me some hell. I don't know why I like to do that kind of stuff. I guess I wasn't through fooling myself.
Yeah, and I used to have a smoking little fastball guy.
Yeah, he did.
I sure could show him some stuff. Well, I can't even make it on a church team anymore. Looks like I'm finally through fooling myself.
So hang on just as long as you can. Get up whenever you fall. Shake it off, boys, and go around again. Don't be hanging your life on the wall. Just as long as you can.
does out in radio land, the big clam on the end was mine. This is Guy. Everybody in the audience saw me do it. I just got to thinking, man, this is so good. And forgot that I was playing.
Now I got to ask a fan question for a minute. Guy Clark, what? I came to town because I listened to Old Number One and I had to come to town and be you. I'm still got a long way to go. Who inspired you?
Well, a whole lot of different things. My favorite songwriter is Towns Van Zandt, always has been. But growing up in Texas, there's this whole mishmash of musical influences. There's Mexican music, Cajun music, black music, country music, all these indigenous groups that sell, the Germans and the Czechs, they keep all of that music going. And, you know, it's just, you start taking it for granted. But all of those are influences on me. Yeah. You know, I mean, I like everything. The first year I played the guitar, I didn't know any songs in English. It's like all Mexican music. I mean, I'm influenced by everything I hear, you know, from Pablo Casals to Lightning Hopkins.
How old were you when you knew that this was what you were supposed to do?
What day is it? I got hooked on it first time I saw anybody sit in a room and play a guitar. I was about 16, 17. But I didn't commit to it until I was like 30. Wow. I'm still of that generation. Well, you have to have a job. Oh, yeah, man, I forgot.
Yeah. Whoops.
Oh, yeah. And finally, I just quit asking myself that, or saying that to myself.
You know. Good for you.
So anyway.
And you know, and you're back into something you did a long time ago, which is building guitars. Mm-hmm. Now, you were actually building and fixing guitars before you were really writing and singing and performing, right?
Yeah, yeah.
I was over at Guy's house the other day, and he's got a little shop down there. It's kind of a flashback from a while back, and he's got a classical guitar almost made.
Yeah, flamenco guitar I'm just about finished with. And Verlon, that's playing guitar with us, he's building one too. Wow. So we are luthiers.
All right.
What's the difference between a flamenco guitar and a classical guitar?
They make flamenco guitars to be very percussive, and even they build in string rattle, so it becomes a percussion dance instrument. That's what it's for, as opposed to this real mellow, deep, pristine sound.
Right.
I mean, it's meant to be clattery.
Funky.
Yeah.
Well, y'all have been just real sweet about this whole thing. We're going to do one more song. We'd like to thank Dave. All the folks at PBS. Rebecca Bain, we always want to have you introduced your percussionist?
About 1,000 times, but 1,001 would be good. No, we have many times. Sam Bacco on percussion.
Yeah!
That's good. I need to be reminded of things like that. Hey, Guy, thank you for being here.
This is
really special.
Well, I wished I was in Austin, in the chilly parlor bar, drinking Mad Dog margaritas and not caring where you are. But here I sit in Dublin, just rolling cigarettes, holding back and choking back to shakes with every breath. So forgive me all my anger, forgive me all my faults. There's no need to forgive me for thinking what I thought. When I loved you from the get-go, and I love you till I die. I loved you on the Spanish steps the day you said goodbye. I am just a poor boy, Works my middle name. If money was a reason, well, I would not be the same.
Will I stand up and be counted? I'll face up to the truth. I'll walk away from trouble, but I can't walk away from you. So forgive me all my anger, forgive me all my faults. There's no need to forgive me for thinking what I thought. I loved you from the get-go, and I love you till I die. I loved you on the Spanish steps the day you said goodbye. Spain, and I have been too proud to come in out of the rain. And I have seen the David, I've seen the Mona Lisa too. And I have heard Doc Watson play Columbus Stockade Blues. So forgive me all my anger, forgive me all my faults. There's no need forgive me for thinking what I thought. I loved you from the get-go, and I love you till I die. I loved you on the Spanish steps the day you said goodbye. Well, I wished I was in Austin, in the chilly parlor bar, drinking Mad Dog margaritas and not caring where you are.
Wow. Guy Clark, Verlon Thompson.
Thank you.
Thank you, Guy.